Det stopper først, når hun dør.
Exo did save my life that day. He took two bullets for me. Fit for a
fallen hero. Det vi laver, det kan altså have fatale konsekvenser for dem ude i den anden ende. Here to honor an officer's
life taken in the line of duty. Two bullets that had my name on it.
If we leave it open, we're gonna have to be pretty quick because he's gonna grab the box.
Because all they show on the news is the bad news.
He had just shot a guy in the head,
and I hear a gunshot.
But he was able to strike Exo twice. Damn. He lived with me. He played with my kids. My kids played with him. It's just, it's tough. And it took a lot out of me for a while.
One down. One down.
Pascagoula ligger i det allersydligste Mississippi ud til den meksikanske golf. Byen med godt 22.000 indbyggere er i dag blandt andet kendt som skuespilleren Channing Tatums barndomsby, og byen, hvor Calvin Parker her sammen med sin far hævdede at være blevet bortført af rumvæsener. Men det er også en by med meget kriminalitet. Derfor har byen også en stor politistation, der er hjemsted for blandt andet politiets narkohunde. En af dem hed Exo.
All of these, it was given to me. People mailed them to me throughout the United States. From overseas, I was sent stuff. It's amazing. I've even got more stuff.
Narkobetjent James Prysock viser en række af de hundredvis af gaver, han har fået tilsendt fra hele verden, da nyheden om drabet på hans danske tjenestehund Exo ramte medierne. Det er godt et halvt år siden, og episoden sidder stadig dybt i den erfarne betjent.
That was my reality on June 23rd of 2022. It's nothing I wanted to do. I didn't imagine that was what was going to turn out when I went into that situation. But Exo did save my life that day. He took two bullets for me.
Jamen, det er jo nok sådan en ting, som man tænker, altså. Det er altid indbrud over ved naboen, det bliver aldrig her. Og så skete det lige pludselig. Vi vidste godt, at det var en risiko, men når vi ikke laver flere hunde, end vi gør, at det så lige skulle ske for en af dem, gør jo også bare, at man bliver mere bevidst om, at det vi laver, det kan altså have fatale konsekvenser for dem ude i den anden ende.
Exo angreb en bevæbnet gerningsmand, da han trak en pistol for at skyde James Prysock. Den dansk trænede hund blev ramt af to projektiler, men angrebet gav James Prysock tid til at trække sit våben og uskadeliggøre gerningsmanden.
I did shoot the suspect multiple times, but he was able to strike Exo twice, once in the hip and once in the chest.
Exo blev efterfølgende erklæret død på et nærliggende dyrehospital. Den danske politihund blev 2 år gammel. Længere nordpå i Mississippi, i byen Hattiesburg, er et hundeførerkursus for betjente i fuld gang. Exos tidligere træner, Jesper Andersen fra Danmark, er rejst til USA for at aflevere hunden Uno.
Here's his passport.
Han har aldrig fået den fulde historie bag Exos død, så han har lavet en aftale med James Prysock om at mødes senere på dagen. Inden da står den imidlertid på narkosøgning i et gammelt autoværksted i udkanten af byen.
This won't take long because you're not searching for it. You're taking them to it, getting it, and marking it.
Yeah.
Go to that market, and once they do all 4 of them, then we can get on to anything else you want to do.
Narkosøgningen er en del af et flere uger langt hundeførerkursus, som Bobba Howell og hans firma Southern State Canine afholder. En lang række amerikanske politienheder kræver, at deres hundefører gennemfører kurset, før de kan arbejde på gaden med deres hunde. Jesper er gæsteunderviser, og nu skal politihundene fra Danmark igen lære nye ting.
Bobber, som har Southern State Canine, har mulighed for at opbevare ægte stoffer. Så det har han med at lagt ud. Og nogle af hundene har nemt ved at gå fra det syntetiske til det ægte, og andre har lidt svært ved det. Men det er det eneste, vi har at gøre med derhjemme. Og for Uno lært at finde de ægte stoffer og kunne være her og hjælpe ham og vise, hvordan jeg har gjort det med ham, er jo pissefedt, fordi så kan han jo se, hvordan jeg har gjort, og så når han selv skal i gang, så bliver det noget nemmere for.
You know, he did all this stuff over in Denmark, and now he's got to get used to being here and being away from Jesper and being with me. So, you know, it's a lot on him, just like it would be a kid. But he's doing well.
Sit down. Yes.
And that was his first time. That's right.
Yeah, that's the first time on marijuana. You want to go to the next one? So on the left. So you can see the metal box on the container over here. Just walk up, point at the source.
Right.
And if he longers like that, tell him to sit.
Okay.
And I know we're putting you on the spot, you know, but if you can be a little more, you know, heavy when he comes back, he did a good job. Yay! Woo.
Sit. Sit. Sit.
Yes! Yes! Good boy!
You know, it's our first time hitting on some things, and he was, you know, a little distracted by some things in there, but he is a year and a half old, so I think he's going to be fine.
Også vicesheriff Timothy Lawson og hans danske politihund Rocky er i gang med hundeførerkurset. Timothy og Rocky har været i gang i 4 uger og har bare 14 dage tilbage, inden de kan gå til eksamen. Rocky er utrolig dygtig, men han har et problem. Han vil rigtig gerne samle de genstande op, han finder. For en politihund er det imidlertid strengt forbudt. En hund, der finder et kilo amfetamin og får det i munden, risikerer at dø af det.
Two things here.
Yes, sir.
We can leave it open like that, or we can close it. If we leave it open, we're gonna have to be pretty quick because he's gonna grab the box.
Yeah. What you could do is leave it open, mm-hmm. and then you know, lead him up on the line like we talked about yesterday, so where he doesn't get the opportunity, you know, to grab it. You want me to reward?
Yeah, if you would.
Ligesom Uno er Rocky stadig en ung hund, og han har lidt svært ved at koncentrere sig. Kokain er stadig en lille smule for spændende, og han har svært ved at lade det ligge. Narkoøvelsen i Hattiesburg er overstået. Alle hundene består. Men Timothy Lawson og Rocky slutter dagen med besked om at fortsætte narkoøvelserne, indtil Rocky har lært at lade stoffet blive liggende.
Det stopper aldrig. Altså. Det stopper først, når hunden dør. Altså. Der er altid et eller andet at arbejde med, der kan blive bedre. Så sådan er det.
Planen er i dag, at vi laver lidt opstart på narkosø. Ikke at de kommer til at søge på decideret narko, men vi laver de indledende øvelser, hvor at de lærer at skal ud og lede efter noget, og så lægger vi færden på senere hen.
Og så, så laver vi lidt bygningssøg, altså hvor hundene skal ind og lede efter en bad guy, og så ind og bide ham.
Uno, Rocky og Greif er langt fra de eneste, som er på vej ud på de amerikanske highways. Hjemme i Danmark er der konstant nye hunde i træning. Jesper Andersen og hustruen Katarina har denne forårsdag yderligere 5 hunde med til et tomt hus i Pejhede Skov. Sig goddag til Canine Bolt, Canine Leo, Canine Gizmo, Canine Kato og Canine Mesa.
Så nu er vi startet op med at lede efter et helt nyt hold, og vi har fundet lidt en blandet landhandel ind. Fra et år til op til 2 år. Så der har jeg 2 chefer og en malinois nu, som jeg så skal til at starte helt forfra igen med at lære at gå spor og bide og finde narko. Så
kom, kammerat.
Om et halvt års tid, så er den første hund nok klar, og så begynder de ellers at komme i en landstrøm derefter. Altså hele ideen med det her, det er jo at skabe en interesse for hunden og komme ud og lede efter noget.
Sådan, dygtig dreng.
Og nu er det en bold, så han får en belønning ved at gå ud og lede efter det. Så det er jo lige så stille opstarten på at lære hunden, jamen seek betyder gå ud og lede efter noget, og så er der gevinst på et eller andet tidspunkt. Så nu vil jeg egentlig bare gerne have, at han kommer ud og leder efter det, og synes det er pisse sjovt det her. Så senere hen, når han kommer over til Dave over i USA, så begynder han lige så stille at lægge færd på, altså narko.
Ja da.
Ja da. Sådan det her.
Så ro, min ven. Ikke også?
Udover de 5 nye hunde har Jesper også valpen Burner.
Du må sikkert være fuld lille hele tiden.
Den lille malinois er søn af Jespers egen tjenestehund, Boss.
Kom. Sit.
Burner er familiens maskot, men alligevel er planen, at han skal sælges til amerikansk politi, når han er 1,5 år gammel.
Se,
Burner han lige knap 1,5 år nu. Og han er rigtig godt med i træningen. Hun siger, nu har jeg haft ham siden han var 8 uger gammel.
Så fin, drengen.
Ja. Så jeg har kunnet sætte mit præg på ham helt fra starten af. Så han er lidt længere i træningen end de andre. Han kan godt komme ud og finde bolden og markere på den. Og lige snart de så klikker, så ved han, så må jeg tage bolden. Så han er egentlig ikke så langt fra, at vi kan begynde at lægge noget færd af narkotika på ham, så han lærer det at kende.
Amerikanske politihunde skal kunne finde en mulig gerningsmand. Ligesom man kender det fra dansk politi. Men i modsætning til Danmark, så skal hunden ikke bare finde manden og gø af ham. Amerikansk politihunde skal opsøge gerningsmanden og gå til angreb.
Sådan der, det var fint, ikke også?
Derfor skal det nye hold allerede nu i gang med træning i at bide.
Vi leger det ind i hunden, så nu, ligesom med bolden, så gasser vi dem lidt op på et bidestyr. Og så løber jeg ind og gemmer mig. Og så sender Katarina hunden, når jeg lige har fået lov til at komme væk. Og så er ideen jo, at hunden skal ind og lede og bruge sin næse og finde mig. Så de synes, det er pisse sjovt.
Man kan godt se, alt det her bid, det er nyt for ham. Så han er meget, meget usikker. Og se, lige snart jeg prøver at presse ham lidt og råbe af, så trækker han sig. Så der er i hvert fald noget at arbejde med der. Nu kan man se med Kato, som er 2 år gammel og har noget træning. Meget, meget, meget bedre at bide. Han holder det. Og det er helt dybt. Og nu begynder jeg at lægge noget pres på ham.
Sådan der.
Med hundredvis af timers intens træning er ambitionen, at hundene til sidst forstår deres opgave ned i mindste detalje og lystrer hver eneste kommando uden at tøve. Jespers egen tjenestehund, Boss, har adskillige mesterskabspokaler stående i skabet, og han er nærmest umulig at snyde.
Slip! Tissimyr. Kagemand. 5 år. Tissemand.
Tillykke!
Saftevand. Kagemand. Tag!
Au, min mormor, min skider.
Jeg er jo rigtig glad for den måde, de søgte efter bolden på. Jeg kan godt se med bide, og det her med at skal ind og lede, og især på miljøet på nogle af dem, har vi noget at arbejde med. Men det ville også være kedeligt, hvis der ikke var noget at arbejde med. Ja. Så altså, jeg er rigtig glad for det træning, vi har fået lavet, og så også, at nu har vi fået øjnene op for, hvad vi skal arbejde videre med. Så alt i alt en god dag.
Tell y'all a little story about the first time I let a woman get the best of me. I met her at a house party on the west side. Didn't think I'd get her attention after I saw the rest try. But we had shit in common. We both ain't tall. We both smoke and drank they ball. And her bra was stuffed. I mean, baby, look sweet. Gang of brown skin.
I Pascagoula i det sydlige Mississippi er Jesper Andersen og den amerikanske narkobetjent James Prysock begge på vej mod hjørnet af Astor og Larkspur Street i udkanten af byen. Det var i området her, at den danske politihund Exo reddede James Prysocks liv, da den blev ramt af to projektiler. Jesper, der trænede Exo i Danmark, har aldrig fået den fulde historie om, hvad der skete den dag hunden blev skudt, men i dag får han vished.
Det var ret nok at lige vide, hvad der skete, og se, hvor det skete.
Hvis en politihund omkommer på arbejdet i Danmark, vil det være et tab for politiets hundeafdeling i byen, hvor hunden kom fra. Resten af Danmark ville næppe registrere dødsfaldet. I USA er sagen imidlertid en anden. Befolkningen ser politihunde som fuldgyldige politibetjente, der hver dag sætter livet på spil for at beskytte amerikanerne. Derfor er drabet på en politihund lige så stor en nyhedshistorie som drabet på en betjent.
NBC 15's Darwin Singleton was there for the send-off, fit for a fallen hero.
They began to assemble in Mobile just before 10. Scores of law enforcement officers from across the Gulf Coast, here to honor an officer's life taken in the line of duty. Moments later, men and women clad in uniforms from different departments, standing at attention as that officer's adopted family carried his remains to a waiting car for that ride back to Pascagoula.
Både drabet på hunden Exo og den efterfølgende begravelse blev dækket af amerikanske medier i et omfang, der langt overstiger de fleste danskers fatteevne. Årsagen skal findes i den amerikanske befolknings grundlæggende respekt for folk i offentlig tjeneste. Især soldater og betjente hører dagligt sætningen: pas på dig selv og tak for din indsats.
When we went and picked Exo up and escorted him back to Pascagoula, the amount of people on the side of the road with signs that said, "We love you, we miss you, Exo." There's no words for me to say how amazing that was. And you know, like I said, they're a police officer. Exo had a badge number, and he was honored as a police officer after he died.
Because this dog was a police dog, there's just an outpouring of support that comes out, and you'll get people who might be on the other side of the U.S. and they'll get a hold of you like, "Hey, I want to buy you another dog because of the things that the time that you spent with that one. I want to replace it." And I don't know how to explain the outpouring of support that you do get.
If an officer is unfortunately killed in the line of duty, then they post their stuff online and on the website. They'll post the canine also, but then they have their own End of Watch website also.
There's a lot more support out there than what's shown, because all they show on the news is the bad news and the people who hate the police. But even if they've never seen the dog, there's people that donate money just to donate money because it's a police dog. It's crazy.
Og taknemmeligheden opleves ikke bare i befolkningen. Pascagoula Police Department valgte efter Exos død at tildele hunden tapperhedsmedaljen i taknemmelighed for det offer, som hunden gav den dag i juni 2022.
Yeah. No, gets in there, you mean?
Yeah. It's just so...
What about the recall? We're going to recall him back, have the handler come over here and get in that?
Yeah.
På hundeførerkurset i Hattiesburg handler det også om tapperhed. David Klimek, Bob Howell og Jesper Andersen har besluttet, at hunde og hundeførere skal presses maksimalt. Til lyden af Mississippis insisterende cikader skal de nu finde en gerningsmand i totalt mørke, under trange og klaustrofobiske forhold i et netværk af underjordiske tunneller.
Figuranten har selvfølgelig kravlet igennem de her rør, der under jorden først, så der er noget færd til hundene, så de ved, eller har en idé om, hvilken vej de skal. Så hundeføren startede dernede, og så blev hunden sendt ind igennem alle de her rør under jorden, og så skal hunden finde frem til en figurant, der står herovre med et bidærm på, som de unge hunde, de vinder, og så kommer de tilbage herover til, hvor hundeføren står og kalder på hunden, og så kravler de sammen ud igen.
So after he sends them in, the handler should crawl through the tunnel after him to here.
Yeah.
Recall him to here and then take him out.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know if Dennis can crawl through these tubes. Is he the decoy?
Yep.
Yeah. You are kind of a big fella to get that little hole down there.
Gets smaller.
Yeah, that's too small. If you wouldn't eat that big old piece of pizza for lunch, you probably could have done it.
Den første hund i tunnelerne er Rocky, der nu skal finde Dennis Riber et sted i netværkets mørke. Hunden kan intet se og må klare sig med færd og hørelse.
Is Dennis ready? Sheriff's canine, come with your hands up and release the dog, you will be bit. Sheriff's canine, come out with your hands up and release the dog, you will be bit. That's fine, Gordon. Sheriff's canine, come out with your hands up and release the dog, you will be bit.
Woo!
Rocky klarer tunnelerne helt uden problemer. Næste hund er Uno, som Jesper netop har afleveret til vicesheriff Chandler Guy.
Nu er det første gang, han prøver noget så vildt her, så med en ny hundefører. Så nu må vi se, eller så må vi lige tilpasse. So I told them, when you're ready here, Dennis is gonna make some noise before we send him. Okay. So he has a reason to run in there.
You ready? You ready?
Sheriff's office, canine, come here, you will be bit. Strike!
No, no, it's not necessary. Ah! Oh! 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 Whoa! Whoa! Ah!
Oh, good boy. Oh, good boy. Hey, ooh. That was good.
Yeah, what do you think?
It was good. He got a little confused at one of them tunnels, but he did good. Was it a good? He bite good down there?
Yeah.
It took him a while on that turn.
Yeah.
Because he kept hearing, I guess, the echo of it. He kept bouncing back and forth, but he did good.
Yes. You did.
Jeg er positivt overrasket over, at han rent faktisk kommer derud, fordi det er en svær øvelse, det her. Og han render rundt dernede i mørket alene, altså. Det er svært, det her.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, good boy.
Mens mørket trænger sig på, og dukken falder, fortsætter træningen i kloakkerne i Hattiesburg, indtil alle politihunde har bestået øvelsen.
Hi, James.
Jesper?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, finally.
I'm finally glad I got to meet you.
Yeah, me too, even though it's under these circumstances.
It is, but what you did, you know, training next to that saved my life, and I've been wanting to meet you and thank you for that.
Oh, well, you're welcome. I'm just happy you got to go home that day.
Me too.
Yeah.
Me too.
Efter flere dage i USA er det endelig lykkedes for Jesper Andersen og narkobetjenten James Prysock at finde et hul i deres travle kalendere. De to mødes for første gang nogensinde, præcis på hjørnet af Astor og Larkspur Street i Pascagoula, hvor den dansk trænede politihund Exo blev skudt og dræbt under eftersøgningen af en formodet drabsmand for 6 måneder siden.
I had just shot a guy in the head and killed him and then took off into the woods. After he shot and killed him.
The homicide that he was a suspect in happened a street over. A neighbor saw the suspect pop out of the woods. There was an officer still on scene, and so they came and set up a perimeter on this street and the next street over, surrounding it. So if he popped out of the woods, they would see it. They would know where he was at.
We can cut through right here.
Once we cut through the woods, there's a field over here. And once we cut through the woods, Exo backtracked until we got about right here. Once we got right here, Exo picked his head up and he started wind sitting, which told me at that point that, hey, the guy's right here. So I took Exo's leash off because I didn't want him getting tangled up in this thick briars. And me and him ran into the woods. As soon as we get into the woods, I don't even see him yet, and I hear a gunshot. Right after the gunshot, I looked up, and I see the guy laying on the ground on his back, and he's holding the gun pointed at me.
And I started firing my weapon. At the same time, Exo was going to apprehend the bad guy. I did shoot the suspect multiple times. But he was able to strike Exo twice, once in the hip and once in the chest.
And then I remember looking down and I remember seeing Exo using his front paws and crawling to me.
Yeah.
He couldn't use the back half of his body. And I remember thinking, oh my God, he's paralyzed. I immediately scooped Exo up and I'm calling on the radio, get me a patrol car out here. As I'm running out of the woods, a patrol car pulls up here. I jump in the back seat and we drive to Mobile to the emergency vet.
I only had him for 9 months, you know, and in that 9 month period, Exo, he did some amazing things. He found a lot of narcotics on traffic stops that we did together. He found bad guys hiding from us.
And I knew it was getting bad because the closer we got to the hospital, the less alert he got.
Okay.
And it's when we got to the hospital, he was pretty much limp at that point.
Yeah.
He lived with me. He played with my kids. My kids played with him. He ran around my farm whenever I was out working, playing around. He came to work with me. Pretty much, if I wasn't in the woods hunting, then Exo was with me. And you know, going from that to nothing is just—it's tough.
And they did everything they could. They were a great vet. They did everything they could to try to save his life, but
yeah.
His injuries were too bad.
Yeah. Did he shoot him once or twice or did
twice?
Okay.
It was twice. Yep. Shot him twice with 2 bullets that had my name on it. 100%. And, you know, Exo saved my life because of that.
Yeah.
What's up? It's Deputy Guy, K9-UNO. Been back for a few weeks now. We've gone out on a search warrant with U.S. Marshals. done a few narcotic searches with him, got a lot of training in. We actually just got done putting out some narcotic finds.
Hey guys, Deputy Lawson, K-9 Rocky, just updating y'all.
Still very pleased with everything that's been going on with him. Done a lot of obedience. Our bond is extremely strong.
Rocky has been utilized to seize multiple ounces of meth and fentanyl, along with other various narcotics since he's been back, resulting in multiple seizures of vehicles and cash.
Kind of like a small child. If I get out of his sight for a few minutes, he gets pretty wound up.
On March 30th, me and Rocky located a stolen vehicle where it led into a vehicle pursuit. After about an 18-mile pursuit, the subject wrecked out and began shooting at us, where he barricaded in the woods. After an extensive standoff, we deployed K-9 Rocky to track the subject, where he was eventually taken into custody.
But just wanted to check in, let y'all know that everything's been going well. Excited with his progress. Looking forward to things in the future. Y'all be safe.
I can't wait to keep y'all up to date on the success that me and Rocky continue to have here in the United States. On Derek.